Well, from executive producers including Brad Pitt and Maya Rudolph, and fresh off an award-winning premiere at Sundance, comes the new movie, The Last Black Man in San Francisco.
Yeah, the film follows one man's efforts to reclaim the house his grandfather built, with Tichina Arnold playing his tough but loving aunt. Take a look.
Daddy didn't send you here, right?
No.
You sure?
I swear to God.
Because I hope he's done dragging you into his schemes.
Auntie, this is for us.
Okay. I'm proud of you, J-Bo. Really am.
Thank you.
Oh! Ooh! You still look good, though, baby. A dirty old woman.
I know.
Oh, like of all promos, man.
That's the one. Oh, welcome back. It's good to have you here.
Thank you. So happy to be with you ladies once again. You know, this is a ritual for us.
I know. We love it when you come. And congratulations on being a part of this film. We talked, you know, we described it as a young man trying to reclaim this home that his grandfather built. But how do you describe this movie?
Oh, my God. This movie is a piece of artwork. It's a poem, a big poem. It's not your average movie. It's, of course, shot in a way that I've never, ever seen before. Yeah. It's just so beautifully lit and shot. And I think Joe Talbot and Jimmy Fails really put their foot in it with this movie. It's expressive. It's a movie that you walk away leaving differently.
Yeah.
You learn more about San Francisco. You learn about gentrification. You learn about black men. Mm-hmm. I always say black men are everything because there are so many facets to a black man.
Yeah, yeah.
And that unfortunately, when black men are vulnerable, we see them in the back of a police car or dead in the middle of a street from being shot. This movie is a movie that shows a black man's vulnerability in a way where it's just so beautiful.
It's beautiful.
It is so beautiful.
Yeah, and so this, you mentioned Jimmy and the director. It's based on
Jimmy's real lives
together.
Yeah, they grew up together. They came up together in San Francisco.
Yeah, so what was it like for you to be part of this as they're bringing their story to the screen?
Well, Rob Morgan and I, who's amazing in this film, he plays Jimmy Fails' dad. We were the only New York, you know, the East Coast. I'm from New York, he's from the DMV, so I had to get rid of my New York accent, kinda, so I learned how to say hella, you know, that's hella good, everything is hella, but, you know, it's just an amazing experience doing this, you know, working with A24 and Plan B is my first time doing a production through them, so that's awesome, too,
it's not bad working
with Brad Pitt's company. Yeah. Hey, Brad, what's up, boo? this movie, I hope, changes lives. I hope it changes the perspective of what people think about black men or how they think black men or how black men have been perceived.
Yeah.
It's not a lot. I'm actually the love affair. There is no woman love affair in the movie. The love affair is the house.
Yeah.
You know, it talks about being displaced, you know, in your home. Like everybody loves home. You want some place that you could call your home. This movie is about hope. There's no redemption in this movie, actually, this movie is about hope, and I just hope that this movie can be played in schools.
Yeah.
I think this movie should be shown to people to give them a little more sensitivity about people who are not rich. You know, the middle class is going away in America right before our eyes. So there's so many displaced people and young people living in the streets.
Yeah,
I mean,
this is their story, man. This is it. It's so beautiful.
This movie is a voice. This movie is going to be a voice for them.
Yeah. It's a side of San Francisco you never even.
Oh my God! And the history in San Francisco.
Yeah.
And San Francisco is like a melting pot. When I first moved to California, I used to miss New York. I would fly to San Francisco to feel like I was in New York.
Yes.
Yes, because it's colder and the people there are just amazing people. Everybody is like, it's a melting pot.
Well, we got to talk about this hilarious show you're a part of over on CBS.
That little show.
Congrats, it got picked up for season 2. That's very exciting.
Yes, thank you, God. We got picked up for another season. This is, I mean, working with Cedric the Entertainer and my girl Beth Bears and Max Greenfield and Marcel Spills and Shion. It's just a great group of people.
It looks like
great
so much
group
fun.
Of people.
You got to come back and talk about that and everything else
you're involved. Me back, because you know I love promoting myself.
Anytime.
Hey.
And we're going to get you on Ripley's.
Oh, no, listen. This is the best I can do for Ripley's. Here we go. That's
it.
I can't even twerk, y'all, so I'm going to do the Ripley's.
The Last Black Man in San Francisco hits theaters this Friday, so check it out. Tichina, it's always great to have you here.
So
congrats on everything.
Thank you.